Hello and welcome back to the channel. If you have a mouse or rat problem, these traps will work. Rats have been getting into my storage room in the back of the yard by chewing through the window screens. I've tried all kinds of rat poisons and felt like I was only feeding them. So I started looking into rat traps and I found these and I got great results after 2 hours of placing one down. I found these at Home Depot. The mouse trap was $5. And the rat trap was $10. Here we have the mouse trap and the rat trap side by side in comparison. And as you can see, the mouse trap is very small. The rat trap is very big. I haven't used the mouse trap yet, but the rat trap is the one I use all the time. They both come with 12 rings. The mouse trap has the rings there, and the one for the rat trap. Same size rings. You can also go online at Amazon. Get 100 pack, about $8 online. These rings are very easy to put on. Start at the tip, and you roll it all the way back here, and then you lock it in place. They're very slippery. Pain. Get it to the very end. Right in there. All the way around. This is your lock. This red switch. That's ready to trap, and you lock it. Lock it in place. Here we got the mouse trap with the ring loaded. Very small opening. That's the trigger right there. Mouse goes in, it hits that up like this. Mouse down. Same with the rat. It's locked right now. Let me release it. Okay, so release. Same thing. Rat goes in. The head touches that latch right there, that lever. Rat down. Now for bait. Here's what I use. Hershey's chocolate or Tootsie Roll. Make sure you break up the chocolate small, because it has to fit. It has to fit right here. Right in this loading spot is where the bait goes. And I use peanut butter. They love this stuff. This peanut butter is only for the rats. It doesn't get used for anything else. So the way I add the bait is I get the peanut butter first, get a little scoop, take a small little piece of chocolate, and I mix it. And put it right here, in that little slot. Even I want to get it. I bring a napkin. So now you get your trap. Make sure it's locked. See the red switch? Push it forward to lock it or back to release. So we're going to put it forward. And you put it right here. And then you push forward. It's locked. And locked in place. Once you're done, set it where you want to set it, and a lock here. And now it's ready. Just don't forget to pull that lever back, or they're just going to eat your bait and get away. That happened to me once already. So with all that said, This trap will always get them. You won't be disappointed. The only problem I had is when one rat goes in, gets hit with the trap, another one goes in, it takes the bait. And I was like, what the hell? And I came up with a solution. Because this trap, no rats left behind.
Really, nigga?
So when I first started with the trap, I had this one here in the middle. Rat will come in, hit the trap. Another one comes in and take the bait and leave. So when it got two more, and created this one, this masterpiece. So if one rat goes in, hits the trap, another one comes and takes the bait. Now he's got to go into another trap and get more bait, and he gets hit. Now if another rat comes in and goes in here and takes the bait, he's got to go over here, and he'll get the bait. Well, he won't get the bait. He'll get the trap. So this works out pretty good for me. So this whole setup here works very well. I went and got this trap yesterday with the two little ones. I don't think I'm gonna have any use for the little ones. I haven't seen any mouse or mice or whatever. These work pretty fine. I got this one just to start the intro of the video, since this was already set up. Get down in the comments below and let me know what you guys think about this setup. I hope this video was able to help you. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to hit the like and subscribe if you haven't already.